Hello students, so in today's video we are going to discuss the graph of position time, right? How to calculate divergent velocity, what do you mean by slope of the graph, what is intercept, what is the equation of a straight line. These are the things which we are going to discuss in this video. Well, graph is a very effective way, or you can say a mathematical way, to calculate any physical quantity, right? See, we had already discussed the formula to calculate average velocity, right? That means average velocity is displacement by time. Average velocity is displacement by time. And what is displacement? Displacement is final position of the object minus initial position upon time taken. Okay, fine. So first we'll calculate average velocity with this formula, and then we'll see how to calculate the same average velocity in the graph, right? See, we'll take one example. Suppose I am making a table of position of the object and time taken. Let us say object is at 0 meter, position is in meter, time is in second. Okay, right? Object starts from origin at t equals to 0. Let us say that it travels a distance of 2 meter in every 2 seconds. 2 meter in 2 seconds, 4 meter in 4 seconds, 6 meter, 6 seconds, and so on. Right? Okay. So, suppose we are calculating average velocity between 2 to 4 seconds. Right? Between 2 to 4 seconds. So, initial position is 2 meter between 2 to 4 seconds. That means at 2 seconds, the position of the object is known as initial position. So, this will be the initial position, right? 2 second. Final position, 4 meter, right? We are calculating, say we are calculating average velocity between the time interval 2 to 4. So at 2 seconds, the position of the object is known as the initial position, which is 2 meter. 4 meter, the final position is 4 meter is the final position at time 4 seconds. So from the definition, average velocity is displacement by time. Displacement means final position, that is 4, initial position, that is 2, time taken will be 4 minus 2, so that is 2. So 1 meter per second is the average velocity. Clear? This is the velocity which we have calculated by using the formula, right? So how to obtain the same velocity, how to obtain the velocity from the graph of position time? Okay, see, first we'll plot the graph. For this case, position time, x represents a position, t is the time. Let us draw the graph of position time for the same case. It is 0, 2 meter, 2 seconds, right? Then 4 meter, 4 seconds, 6 meter, 6 seconds, right? Join the points. So this is how the graph will look like. Okay. Fine, see, of course the graph is not 100% perfect because I didn't use scale or something like that. Okay, see, now how to calculate the average velocity from the graph? Extend this line. Of course, you can extend this line or you can take this line. Mark angle theta. Say this as triangle PQR. Okay, see, theta you can mark it from here also, theta you can mark it from here also, no problem. See, in physics, one point is to be clear: theta is always, or rather we'll say that anticlockwise angles are taken positive. Anticlockwise angles are taken positive. Clockwise angles are taken negative. this will be helpful to you in your 12th standard also. And always mark theta from positive x-axis and in anti-clockwise direction. Clear? Always mark theta from positive x-axis and in an anti-clockwise direction. That means if anti-clockwise angle is given, take it as positive. Clockwise angles, if it is given in the question, that will be taken as negative. So see, I have marked theta in anti-clockwise direction and from the x-axis. If this is the x-axis, this will be also x-axis. Clear? Clear? See. Now, in this triangle PQR, let us use tan theta. What is the definition of tan theta? Opposite side upon adjacent side. So this will be the opposite side, right? This is 2, this is 4, so this will be 2. Okay, so opposite side, if this is 2, then of course this will be also 2 upon adjacent side. This is 4, this is 2, this will be 2. So tan theta is equals to 1. Tan theta is equals to 1. But what is 1? Velocity. 1 is the 1 meter per second is the velocity. That means tan theta has given me average velocity. So this tan theta is known as slope of the graph. It is known as slope of the graph, which is denoted by m. So one thing we can conclude is the slope of the graph x by t, which is tan theta, will give me average velocity. Clear? Clear? Of course, if you are taking theta and using this triangle, answer will remain the same. That means the graph of position time, the slope of graph position time will give me average velocity, and slope is known as tan theta. Clear? See, now let me give you the standard equation of a straight line. Y equals to mx plus c. This is the standard equation to represent a straight line, where y represents dependent quantity, m represents slope, that is tan theta, that is what we had seen. X represents independent quantity, c is known as y intercept. So this is the equation of a straight line. Y equals to mx plus c. Y means dependent quantity, x means independent quantity. Of course, we'll see few examples, so it will be very clear to you. M is the slope, that is tan theta, which we had removed. C is known as y intercept. It is not intersect, it is intercept. Intercept means distance from the origin to the point where line cuts the y-axis, that is known as intercept, right? The point where the line cuts the y-axis, that point and origin, that distance is known as intercept. That means if this is the line, you are drawing the line like this. So this line is cutting y-axis here. So this is the origin. This vertical distance, this is known as intercept. Clear? See, since the distance is above the y-axis, this intercept is positive in this case, right? But if we are drawing the line like this, then in this case, the distance is below the y-axis, right? So this distance will be, intercept will be negative. And if the line passes through origin, then suppose this way, this way, then intercept will be 0. Then intercept will be 0. So intercept can be positive, can be negative, can be 0. Okay, fine. Now what does this dependent independent quantity represents? See, suppose if I am writing this way, y is equals to 3t plus 2. This is all. So this is the equation of a straight line. Substituting t equals to 0, 1, 2 and so on, y will change, of course. So that means y depends on t. This is dependent quantity, independent quantity, slope, intercept. Clear? Okay, see. One thing more. In many competitive exam, you can directly from the graph, you can decide whether the slope will be positive or negative. Right? That means if theta is less than 90, that is if theta is acute angle, marked from positive x-axis and in anti-clockwise direction, then slope, that is m, will be positive. Right? That means if theta, which is less than 90, it is the angle which is marked from positive x-axis and in an anti-clockwise direction. That is, if theta is less than 90, then the slope of the line will be positive. That means tan theta will be positive. If theta is greater than 90, theta equals to 90 will not be possible because tan 90 is infinite, not defined. Theta is greater than 90, that is if it is making obtuse angle, then slope will be negative. These two points will be important for your competitive exam. Right? Directly from the graph, you can judge whether the slope is positive or negative. So every time you don't have to waste the time to calculate the slope. Clear? See. Let us draw four graphs with different cases. Right? Suppose case one, when I won't want my slope and intercept both as positive. If both I want to be positive, then one thing is sure, for slope to be greater than 0, theta should be less than 90. So line will be somewhere, the line will be, graph will be this way. C is, this is y-intercept, since it is above y-axis, right? Above means it is in positive direction, so intercept is greater than 0, and theta, this is your x-axis, this is theta, this is less than 90, so slope is also positive. Clear? What if I have been told to draw the graph such that intercept should be positive, slope should be negative? Okay, now I want my slope to be negative, so I will draw the graph in such a way that theta will be greater than 90. This way. See, intercept is positive because line is cutting in upward direction. This values are positive, this values are negative, right? And see, theta is greater than 90, so slope will be negative. What if I want both to be negative? Then line should cut this way. See, now the distance is below origin, so intercept is negative and theta is greater than 90, so slope of the line is also negative. Clear? Okay, now what if I want slope to be positive, intercept to be negative? So I will draw the graph in such a way that theta should be less than 90, this way. Okay? So this intercept is negative, this is theta less than 90. So from the graph directly you can observe whether the slope will be positive or will be negative by marking the angle. just by marking the angle. Clear? Okay, fine. So we have seen that the slope of the graph x by t will give me average velocity. Slope means tan theta, right? So whenever the graph of x by t is given and you are being told to calculate average velocity, use tan theta. Okay, fine. We have seen the equation of a straight line, standard equation mx plus c, and what is m, slope, what is c, y intercept. Okay, fine. Now let us draw a graph for this situation. Suppose car is at a distance of 6 meters 0 seconds. That means starting point of the car is 6 meters. Every 2 seconds car is coming closer. That means car is coming towards origin, right? That means suppose we have started from our home, we have reached some place, and now we are returning back. Now we are returning back. In the same way, this is the situation, right? Car is here, t equals to 0, this is 6 meter and it is heading towards origin. So after 2 seconds, it will be at a distance of 4 meter, after 2 seconds, 2 meter, and finally it will be at 0 meter. Okay, so now in the present case, suppose we have been told to calculate, find average velocity from or between 4 to 6 seconds, come on. So with the help of formula, this is the final position. Final position is 0 at time 6 seconds. What is the initial position? 2 meter, 4 seconds. Yes, we are getting the point. It had moved from 2 meter to 0 meter. So 0 will be the final position, 2 will be the initial position. Clear? So in this case, velocity will be final position minus initial position upon time taken. Okay. So final position is 0, initial is 2, time taken is 2. So your answer is minus 1. So of course velocity can be negative. But one thing is sure, object is traveling with uniform speed. That means it's performing uniform motion. Uniform motion means where the velocity remains constant. Whether it is plus or minus, that is okay. But in the previous case, we had got velocity as 1 meter per second. That also represents uniform motion. This also represents uniform motion. Now let us draw the graph of this condition, position time. See, object is at a distance of 6 meter 0 second, then 4 meter 2 second, yes, then 2 meter 4 seconds, right? Join the points. This is how the graph will look like. See, directly from the graph you can say that since theta is greater than 90, slope will be negative, velocity will be negative. Okay, now let us mark this angle theta. Let us say this triangle is PQR. Of course you can take this theta and this triangle also, answer will be same. Tan theta, that will be the slope, that will give me average velocity. Clear? So what is tan theta? PQ upon QR. But now PQ will be 2 minus 4 final minus initial upon time 2. So your answer is minus 1. See, slope has given me average velocity. Clear? But this graph represents uniform motion. Object is traveling with constant velocity. Okay. Now what if the object is not changing the position with time? That means suppose we'll see another graph. Object is, let us say, at a distance 5 meter. After 2 seconds, same position. After 4 seconds, same. And after 6 seconds, same. That means object is at rest. If object is at rest, there will be no velocity. So for this case, the graph will look like object is at a distance of 5 meter at 0 second. After 2 seconds, 5 meter. After 4 second, 5 meter. After 6 second, 5 meter. Join the points. This is how the graph will look like. So you cannot mark any slope here. There is no theta. Theta is 0. So tan theta will be 0. So slope is 0. That means velocity is 0. Clear? So this was the graph of uniform motion. That means object is moving with constant velocity. And this graph is when object is at rest. But how to calculate the velocity for non-uniform motion? Uniform motion means when object is moving with constant velocity. That is known as uniform motion. But how to calculate the graph if the object is not moving with uniform velocity? Suppose, what if the graph of x by t is drawn this way? This way. Or what if the graph looks like this? This represents non-uniform motion, right? Now in this graph, it is not that you remove the slope at one point and that will be the answer at every point. No, because velocity changes. These are the graph of non-uniform motion, right? That means velocity of the object changes from time to time. So to remove velocity for non-uniform motion, you have to draw a tangent at that particular instant of time, and you have to remove the slope of the tangent. Clear? But that slope will not be the same for each and every point, right? So in simple language, if you are being told to calculate average velocity for non-uniform motion, right, you just have to draw the tangent at the instant of time where you have been told to calculate velocity. Draw the tangent, remove the slope of tangent. That will be the velocity at that particular time, right? See, we'll see an example. Suppose, let us say at this time 2 seconds I have been told to calculate velocity, and at say 6 seconds I want to calculate the velocity. First thing that should be clear is velocity at 2 seconds and 6 seconds might not be the same, right? So the answer, the slope which you are removing at 2 seconds, right, that will not be the slope at 6 seconds, right? So how to calculate velocity at 2 seconds? You have to draw a tangent. This will be theta. You have to remove the slope. You have to remove the slope of this tangent. That will be the velocity at point A. So velocity at point A will be equals to tan theta 1. Now suppose you have been told to calculate velocity at 6 seconds. Again draw the tangent. This is theta 2. So velocity at point B equals to tan theta 2. Clear? See, from the diagram you can say that theta 2 is greater than theta 1. Tan theta 2 is greater than tan theta 1. So one thing is sure, velocity at point B is greater than that at point A. That means object is moving with increasing velocity. Clear? How to calculate velocity for non-uniform motion? You just have to draw the tangent at that particular instant of time, and you have to remove the slope of the tangent at that instant of time. Clear? That slope might not become the same for each and every interval of time. Clear? Slope might be different. Say in the present case only, slope at point B is higher than slope at point A. So velocity at point B is greater than that at point A. Clear? For this graph also, if you have been told to calculate velocity here, of course you must be given some values. So you have to draw a tangent, you have to remove the slope. You have to draw a tangent, remove the slope. Clear? So this represents non-uniform motion where velocity is increasing. Now what if velocity is decreasing? From the graph, how to decide that whether velocity is increasing or decreasing? If the graph is drawn this way, this represents that object is moving with decreasing velocity. Velocity of the object decreases. Say suppose I am marking a point A. I want to remove the velocity at point A. I will draw the tangent. I will remove the slope. So tan theta 1 equals to slope at point A. Now if I want to calculate velocity at point B, again I will draw the tangent. I'll remove the slope. So tan theta 2 is equals to slope at point B. Slope will give me velocity at that instant. Clear? I'll not say average, I'll say at that instant, because the graph is non-uniform. From the diagram, theta 2 is less than theta 1, you can see. So tan theta 2 will be less than tan theta 1. Okay, so velocity at point B will be less than A. So in this case, velocity is decreasing, velocity is increasing, but both the graph represents non-uniform motion. Clear? Done. So in this video, we had discussed all the graph of uniform and non-uniform motion for position time. In the next video, from the graph, how to calculate average velocity and the types of graphs, that is what we are going to discuss. Okay?